You lied about your height. And with that, a very warm welcome to the very first episode of Practical Effect Guy. Force Perspective is as old as movies itself. In Citizen Kane, Force Perspective were used to make the sets look bigger. It was used in Eternal Sunshine. There's also Lord of the Rings, and that is our topic today. So first of all, let's quickly talk about the math of Force Perspective. But yeah, I know math is very boring, but you can, it's actually very important. So let's take a look. Is it called math? Math? In Tolkien's universe, humans are around 1.8 meters and hobbits are 1.2 meters. Yeah, for you American guys, here's inch, but it's out of pity. That means that humans and hobbits are in a ratio of 1 to 1.5 for hobbit to human, or 1 to 0.66 for humans to hobbit. Now you can apply those ratios on everything, for example, the different props or even the distance from the camera. But what is actually important if you use Force Perspective? Well, let me break down the sketch for you and I will tell you. And by the way, I realized the sketch with a friend of mine named Kurdan. Well, first of all, very important is the establishing shot to really sell the effect and show the two different heights. That is why we used in the first shot our little body scale double to really show how tall Gaskar actually is. And now that we've established the effect, the different heights, I'm pretty sure most of you guys didn't realize that I scaled up Kurdan's hand to keep up the effect. But I can now show you how ridiculous it looks without his hand scaled up. It totally gives the effect straight away. And here in this shot, I'm actually just on my knees, which is pretty much the most simple way to become Gaskar, dwarf lady. And now the bench sequence. Actually, those are two benches in two different scales. For this bench, I have precisely calculated how big every piece has to be. But that's very important. Only then, if you place one part of your bench closer to the camera and the other further away, and that in exactly the right ratio, then you get the effect. Just use the metric system. But here it's also important that you give a visual cue, and this visual cue are those wooden boxes on top of the benches. With those, your brain won't realize that one bench is actually farther away. And further, but that's a no-brainer, your eye lines won't work anymore. You have to tell your actors where they actually have to look now. It's the small things to make it work. Then after the establishing shot with the bench, we work pretty much with low angles and high angles. And it perfectly makes sense. Now, last but not least, let's talk about props. Those pipes are again in this right ratio, human to hobbit or dwarf. I've actually 3D printed them and colored them, dry brushed them. And here again, the little hand that gives Kurdan the pipe is actually his daughter, our little scale double. And that's pretty much it. That's how you sell your false perspective effect. So in Lord of the Rings, they also used green screen, which I actually did a test, but it still needs some work and it's not totally a practical effect, so I left it out. And they did moving false perspective. Now, that's a little bit more of a kerfuffle, so let me know if I should give it a shot, or if you want to see any other movie effects recreated, comment, subscribe if you want, like. That's it for today. Cheerio!